all you have in store for me is good.
It's good.
Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, I won't worry about tomorrow. I'm trusting in what you say. Today is the day.
Oh, oh, oh.
I will stand upon your truth.
I will stand upon your truth.
All my days I live for you.
All my days I live for you.
Come on, let's sing it.
I will stand upon your truth.
I will stand upon your truth.
All my days I live for you.
All my days I live.
Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, I won't worry about tomorrow. I'm trusting in what you say. Today is the day. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh.
Come on, somebody give him praise.
So we are glad that you're here, and we just hope and pray that you'll just sit back and have a great service. I personally want to wish all of our mothers a happy Mother's Day. I got up this morning, and I went on my Facebook page, and I saw all these beautiful posts and pictures of friends that have put their mother's picture and said these very nice things about their mothers. And I tell you what, if you have a living mother, just praise God. My mother's been gone now since 1995. I miss her. I was my mother's baby boy. She was a charter member of the church that I started in 1990, and she always loved to come to church, and on Mother's Day I can see her. She'd be sitting out just like you are. And she had this big old smile on her face. And we would introduce our mothers, and I'll never forget, my mother was never shy. And she would always stand up and she said, "I'm so glad that I'm in church with my Wayne." That's what she called me, Wayne. And I was her baby boy. So if you got a mother that's living, tell her you love her. And if you can, do something special. And all of you that have adopted mothers, I know I have a lot of adopted mothers as well. I just thank God for mothers. And again, thank you for being here today. How many visitors do we have visiting for the first time? I know we got this couple right here from Cheyenne, Wyoming.
That's a long one.
I preached out in Cheyenne, Wyoming a number of years ago, And see, I'm a Western fan. I always thought that Cheyenne, Wyoming was, and when I went to Cheyenne, Wyoming, I was kind of discouraged for the first time because it's kind of flat land. I was looking for the mountains, but they do have them, believe me, around Jackson Hole and that way. But we're so glad that you're here. Amen. And they came all the way from Cheyenne, Wyoming to be with us this morning. So let's give them all a big hand. Yes.
It's flat, but we're at 6,000 feet. We're actually on top of the mountain.
Amen. And it can get cold here, but it can get cold out there in Wyoming as well. So we're glad that you're here. Anybody else visiting for the very first time? Anybody else? Yes, we're so glad that you. Now, are y'all from Maine originally? Good, good.
Woo-hoo.
All right, let's get all of our visitors a hand. Amen. Last night we attended Linda and I and some of the folks here. We attended Kevin and Kim's first service for MDI, and we had a great time. Real excitement. Kevin is all fired up, and I like that. And as I was telling John this week, I'm so behind Kevin in his ministry. He's yearning to just grab the reins. As any young pastor who's been in the ministry for a number of years, he wants to go full blast, and we need to be behind Kevin and Kim praying for him. Amen?
Amen.
And I know how I was when I was his age. I mean, I was just so full of enthusiasm. And I know Kevin will do a great job. Kevin,
Thank you, sir. You
and Kim, you have a real live ministry ahead of you. And I thank the Lord for you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
So, how many of you want to hear some more good music? Amen? I couldn't hear that. Susan, could you hear that excitement up there? How many of you really want to hear some good, exciting music? Hey, there you go. Go ahead, Kevin.
All right, well, let's stand to our feet. You know, you can praise God all kinds of ways this morning. We want to encourage you just to praise Him, whether it's standing or singing or shouting or spinning around, whatever it is. We want you to feel freedom in this place. Let's give praise to Him.
Great are you, Lord, you're mighty in strength, and you are faithful. Praise you all of our days. It's for your glory today. We offer everything. Raise your hands, all your nations. Shout to God, all creation. How awesome is the Lord Most High. We will praise you together. Trust you when you call our name, and where you lead us, oh God, we'll follow all the way. Raise your hands, all your nations, shout to God, all creation, how awesome is the Lord Most High.
Great are you, Lord.
Great are you, Lord, mighty in strength. 'Cause you are faithful and you will never be. And we will praise you with you of our days. It's for your glory today. We offer everything. So raise your hands, all your nations, shout to God, all creation, how awesome is the Lord.
that.
Hallelujah, awesome. How awesome is the Lord Most High. We sing hallelujah, hallelujah. How awesome is the Lord Most High. Raise your hands, all you nations. Shout to God, all creation. How awesome is the Lord Most High. We will praise you together, both now and forever. How awesome is the Lord Most High. Lord Most High. You are Most High, O God. We give you honor in this place.
Can you do that just with your own words? Just give him honor. Tell him how much you love him. You are beautiful beyond all words, oh God. Your might and your power and your mercy endures forever, God. New every morning. They're new every morning, oh God. Before you're seated, give somebody a handshake, a high five, or bump a rump, or let them know that you're happy to see them today. Oh, a bump a rump. Here, I'll show you what a bump a rump is. Look, see there? There's a bump a rump. You can be seated. God is good, amen?
Amen.
Hey, I just want to say a few words. I was supposed to speak later, and I asked Pastor Wayne if you'd mind if I just interjected my little tidbit. Seriously, it's not much. I just want to share with you a quick thing about today. And first off, I want to appreciate... Could you kill the reverb on my mic? The one who's killing the reverb on my mic. I want to appreciate Gerald and
yes.
Susan. We missed you guys so much. To say things aren't right without you is an understatement. How's that?
Right.
Big time. So appreciate you guys so much. God is awesome. He is so good. And I don't say that just as a pat thing that Christians are supposed to say. You know what I love most about him is just his presence. Just to know that he's here and he's with us. Did you know that God is he's omnipotent, which means he's all-powerful? Did you know he's omniscient, which means he knows everything? But this is the one that gets me. He's omnipresent, which means he's everywhere. Did you know when you came in, what we're doing right now, we're not ushering in the presence of God. He was already here. He was waiting for you. Oh, that's good, isn't it? He was waiting just for you to be here. He couldn't wait for you to be here. In fact, he couldn't wait for you to get in your car because he was already there in your car with you. You know, so sometimes... I don't think we understand that his presence is with us all day long, every day, every single day. And you can experience his presence. You know, and it really just boils down to one word. And that's what I want to focus on. And that's just appreciation. You know, today is Mother's Day and we appreciate our mothers. Do you ever have somebody who you just appreciate being around more than others? You don't have to point them out right now. But the truth is, while I know my wife loves me, I know what brings her the most fulfillment is being around her kids. Amen. Any other mothers like that? Some of you won't admit it. No, it's not being around those things. Get them out of here, right? But for her, her real enjoyment comes from being around her kids. And, you know, that's the kind of appreciation that I'm talking about, is whenever we can find that just being around somebody brings us that kind of joy. And I want to talk about that in terms of God today. Appreciation, just being around his presence. You know, to appreciate means actually to gain value. I don't know if you realize that or not. You know, we talk about appreciating somebody. Johnny will tell you, as soon as you buy a new car and you drive it off the lot, what happens to it?
It depreciates,
right? It falls apart, right, yes. It depreciates right off the bat. So to depreciate means to lose value. But when you appreciate something, you're actually attributing value to it. But there's something magical that occurs when you appreciate something. And it's not so much to the person, it's to you. Suddenly, as you begin to appreciate them, you ascribe value to them for yourself. And it means more to you, right? You know, what you appreciate, and this is the key I want to leave with you, what you appreciate appreciates in your eyes. If you appreciate the presence of God, it means you give value to it. You want more of it. And so today I want to challenge you. How do you appreciate God? Well, Ephesians 5:19-20 says, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves and making music to the Lord in your hearts. And give thanks for everything to God the Father in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's what I'm talking about. When we sing, it's not just about singing, because that's what we do. It's about making music in your heart. I know some people can't carry a tune in a bucket. I get that. I'm not real far from that myself, so I can appreciate that. Appreciate. See what I did there? That's right. Making music and melody in your heart. Sometimes after a song, I'll just play some chords and I'll encourage you to make music in your heart. And it's not because I think, man, we've got a great choir here. It's because I'm encouraging you to give appreciation and thanks. Because that is the key. You want to know the key to experiencing God all day long, every day? Giving thanks and appreciation. You want to sense his presence at work? Give thanks. Show some appreciation. And it doesn't take much. Just, Father, thank you for a beautiful day. This is the day that you've made. Or thank you for a job. In fact, you know, sometimes we don't have to thank God for the good things. It says in every circumstance, 1 Thessalonians 5:18 says, give thanks to God in every circumstance. Because Romans 8:28 says, he's going to work everything out for your good. So you might as well just thank him for it anyway. Amen? Had a young man last night tell me, you know, Kevin, that's a lot easier said than done. And I got to admit, it's a lot easier to say, oh yeah, when you're looking for a job and can't find one, just thank God. When your relationship's real sour, oh, just thank God for it. You know, just thank God that he's going to work it out. It's real easy to do, but you know what? As soon as you start showing appreciation for who God is and that he's so vastly much larger than your problem and can handle it, you'd be amazed at what happens inside of you as you experience his presence. Just in closing, I just want to encourage you. I was thinking back to last night. We had our first study group, our fellowship time at our house for Bar Harbor for MDI. You should come out and try it. It's a good time. There's food. If I'm there, there's food, I promise you. But as we had this room full of people, I kept looking and watching as Kim would walk by, waiting to catch her eye. I wanted her to see that I paid attention, that I saw her. And I'd wait for her eyes to meet mine, and we'd smile. I think it's sad when Christians act like a fellow that brings their wife to a party and ignores him the whole night. But we do, don't we? We have God with us all day long, every day. And I want to encourage you today that today is the start of a day where you can go the whole day long experiencing the presence of God. It's not just meant for in here. It's meant for you at work. Brother Lawrence. Anybody know who Brother Lawrence is? Oh, yeah, Josh. All right, well done. Josh, it's good to see you. Thank you for serving, by the way. We appreciate you. We want to value you, so we appreciate you. Brother Lawrence, sorry, I lost track of where I was. I like Josh. Brother Lawrence, 17th century monk. So you picture the brown hood and the... right? He had it, though, man. He had that thing together. You know what he said? He said... I got to quote it, though, because it's so good. He said, we can do little things for God. I turn the cake that is frying in the pan for love of him. And when that's done, if there's nothing left for me to do, I fall down on my face and worship before him because he's given me strength to work. Isn't that good? We're not talking about a charismatic here. We're talking about a monk, right? Just want to point that out. Afterwards, I rise happier than a king. It is enough for me just to pick up a piece of straw from the ground and do it and show him that I love him. Isn't that amazing? Every little thing you do, your mundane, most seemingly worthless task today can be a sign of how you love him. And so would you stand? I want to just encourage you, and I want to pray a blessing over you before we begin this next song. I want to pray a blessing over you that you'll be infected with his presence all day long. Is that okay? Anybody opposed to experiencing God all day? Just Father, I speak over your people that are gathered here today. I pray that your presence is so very real and tangible to them all day that they become lost in you, whether they're cooking or whether they're just taking a nap, God. Even their dreams would be of you. Father, that we might be in love with you even more. You're absolutely beautiful and wonderful. And I speak a blessing over you and over your people in Jesus' name. Amen. We'd like to sing a love song to the Father with you. This is called So Beautiful. You are so beautiful. There is none that compares to you. Who can take my brokenness and make something new? Only you.
You're beautiful to me. You'll be my song for all eternity. You're overtaking every part of me. You're beautiful to me. A merciful Father, there is none that compares to you. Who can take my bitterness and make something sweet? Only you. You're beautiful to me. You'll be my song for all eternity. You're overtaking every part.
Can we sing that second verse together again?
Merciful Father, there is none that compares to you.
Who can take your bitterness?
Who can take my bitterness?
Tell the Lord he's beautiful.
You're beautiful to me. You'll be my song for all eternity. You're overtaking every part of me. You're beautiful.
Lost.
Yes, I am left in all of you.
I'm left in all of you.
And I am left in all of you. Yes, I am left in all of you.
I'm left in all.
And I am left in all of you. Yes, I am left in all of you. And I am left in all of you. Yes, I am left in all of you.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful to me. You'll be my song for all eternity. You're overtaking every part of me. You're beautiful to me.
You're overtaking every part.
You're overtaking every part of me. You're beautiful to me.
Amen. Give the Lord a praise offering. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
How many of you have prayer requests right now? I know we all do. So if you have a prayer request, just raise your hand, and we're going to pray and just thank the Lord that he says, whatsoever we ask in his name, believing, that shall it be. I believe in prayer, and I want you to continue to pray for Linda and I as we get settled here in Maine. You know, I don't care what you say. When you're our age and you make a move like we made a move, there's a little bit of culture shock. Amen? And I was telling Linda today, I love my wife 44 years. And I told her coming tonight, this morning, I said, Linda, I said, you know, our boys are very busy and Shannon lives in Virginia, David lives in Florida. I said, but you know what? You've been an excellent mother to our two boys. Linda has one that she has gone with me everywhere God called me. You know, 14 years in the Caribbean. Wherever I have gone, she's gone with me. And I can honestly say that she's never complained. And one thing about my wife, and I'm saying this before God and every one of you, I've never, ever heard my wife ever talk about anybody. Never. She just won't do that. She's a special lady and a special friend. So, Lynn, I want you to know I love you, and you are a great mother, just like each and every one of you are. I'm also happy and proud to have a young man in our midst who's a soldier. Now, if you know me, I am proud of our young men. I was in Vietnam for 13 months in 1966, came back in 1967, and I'm going to be honest with you, our generation, when we came back from war, we were the most maligned soldiers I think America has ever seen. When we come back, we were called baby killers. When we come back, we had people that you know, back in the 60s, they were rioting, and they were doing all kind of things to diminish the war. And us young soldiers, we went to war because our government said we had to go to war. And it's not because we wanted to go to war, but because our government said we had to go to war. And so I know how I felt. And I know how I still feel. Because time doesn't ever erase what you went through. Our oldest son, Shannon, had to go to Desert Storm. And he was an M1A Abrams tank commander. And he had three tours over in Desert Storm. And I know what my son went through and what he's still suffering to this day. So all of our young soldiers, we give thanks. And, And Josh, I want you to know that no matter where you go, what you do, we'll be behind you. We'll be behind you. And once we get, and once you get to Korea, don't think that you won't get a baby, because the more you get to know me, my wife will tell you, we always did this to our soldiers of every church that I've ever pastored. And I've only pastored just in my 40 years of ministry, just two or three churches. But don't be surprised that you'll get a big, I mean, I'm talking about a big care package full of candy and everything else that goes with it. We had a young man that was stationed on the U.S. Carl Vinson in our church. And when the war started, Desert Storm, and our church took up and sent him a 100-pound care package. I mean, it had every kind of candy and Vienna sausage or you know, anything we could put in there that we thought that they would like, you know. And I'll never forget, he wrote back and said, you know, Pastor King and Shiloh Church, I want to thank you, because not only did I enjoy it, but everybody else on the Carl Vinson enjoyed it. And they thought that it was so befitting that your church would do that. So we're behind you, Josh. God bless you. And we have any other soldiers here this morning? And then I want to thank this young man over here to my far right. He's sort of like our younger son, David. Looks a lot like David. He's also a firefighter. Our youngest son, David's a firefighter, EMT and a paramedic. And I just want to thank you for standing in the gap. Amen. Well, we're at a time of the service that we want to do another form of worship. And I believe this is very important. And it's a time that we come together. And it's a time that we can search our real heart and motives to serving God. A lot of people serve God out of many different reasons, but this is an area of our life that I believe is very, very important. And when Brother John called me and asked me if I would come to Maine, and I said, well, John, how is the church doing? And he says, well, we've never really taken an offering. We've had an offering box. And I said, John, we're not doing the people any good if we don't encourage the people to give. Because it is a time of worship. It really is. Now, those that know me, Linda and I lived, our ministry was in the Caribbean for 14 years, Jamaica and Belize. I like to go back to the island. And one of the things we did in the islands that I was telling Kevin, our fellowship song, I think it was the best fellowship song that any church could ever have. See, I like a little bit of reggae. I do. Matter of fact, I like a lot of reggae. But we were down on the islands when Bob Marley was still living. This is before he died. And I was able to meet Bob Marley one time at a sing day in Montego Bay. Every August they had a big, what they call Sunfest. All the different bands would come together. And he sang a song that I heard the very first time I fell in love with. It's called One Love. And I when I started Shiloh Baptist Church, now Shiloh Church, when I started that, I said to my music director, I want to use One Love as our fellowship song. Yes, man. Now, I don't know where Bob Marley is right now. Let's all stand. Let's have some fellowship. And when we get through fellowship, we're going to take an offering. Listen to the words. You'll love this song. Sing along with it.
One love. One love.
Come on, everybody, sing. Go ahead, shake someone's hand. Tell them you'll love her. Go ahead. This is fellowship time. Go ahead.
I'd really
grasses grow standard. There ain't no hiding place from the Father of creation. Yeah, yeah.
One love.
I love Susan and Gerald and up in the sound room. They were excited, amen. I tell you, that song grows on you. You know, I don't really believe if you look at the world situation, and I try to be very positive. Sometimes I can be a little negative. You have to understand, I'm a human being just like you are. I have my good days and I have my bad days. If you think I'm perfect, if you think I walk on water, you're wrong. You look at me long enough, you'll find a lot of fault in me. If I look at you long enough, I'll find a lot of fault. Amen? So one thing I've always shared, no matter if it was in the islands or if it was here, don't judge people by your standards. Because you know what? There's none perfect. Because the Bible says what you judge other people with, you'll be judged. And so I don't try to judge people. I try to accept people. And I will tell you something else. We got to love one another. Amen. You know, I'm growing to love a lot of you. I'm just now getting to know you, really. And I just want you to know I really do love you and care for you. And I think once we get to know one another, you'll realize that Linda and I are human beings. And we are real people. So thank you for being here. Now is the time of the part of the service that we can show the Lord how much we love him by just giving our tithes and our offerings to the Lord. And the Bible says that it is a worship. What we give to him, we will get back. We really will. What we honestly give him from our heart, we'll get it back. So I trust and pray. And I know a lot of you have lost your jobs. I know a lot of you will say, well, the economy's terrible. Yes, it is. Linda and I went to the grocery store the other day, and I just looked around, and every time we go to the grocery store, you see what? Price is going up. But you know what? God will meet that need. He really will. So if you're here this morning and you love the Lord, and if you can, you give to the Lord, and I promise you it will be given back to you. I'm going to ask our dear brother John if he'll ask the blessing on the offering. And then after the offering, John's going to come, and we're going to do something special here. We are going to honor our mothers again. So I appreciate, again, like I said, I appreciate each and every one of you. And so those that have prayer requests, you raised your hand. John's going to pray for them as well, and God will meet those needs. Brother John, would you pray?
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to be here this morning, God. It's fun to get together with other folks and have times of fellowship and friendship, God. And God, you've got a plan and a purpose for every life that's here, God. And I know there's a lot of hands raised today that had prayer requests, God. And God, not only do you know each and every request that we have, the Bible says you know every hair is numbered on our head, God. So you know us inside and out, God. And we're praying this morning that you would answer those prayer requests in a positive way, God. I'm sure some of them do the sickness, some of them do financial, could be job losses, could be many things, God, but you know each and every one of them. So we're trusting you to give a divine answer in a supernatural way this morning, because you are a supernatural, all-powerful God. God, for this offering this morning, we thank you for each person that's contributed, God. And God, we pray that you'd bless and multiply it, God. And God, we want to see more fellowships, more churches started in Hancock County, God. We want to see our communities one to Jesus Christ. So just bless each offering that's given. Bless each giver. In Jesus' name, amen.
In the garden.
Oh, I come to the garden, and oh,
Somebody sing. And he walks with me.
How many know what today is? Is it a special day today?
Yeah.
What is it? You know, we've got some special things for mothers to do today, which I'm very excited about today, but I've got to have a couple helpers help me today. So let's see. Who would volunteer to come and help me hand out some flowers? Justin? You do it? And who else? Well, you two ladies would like to do it. We don't very often get ladies to do it. Why don't you two ladies come up here too? How's that? All right. Give them all a hand. We've got two special things we're going to do. We're going to hand out flowers, and then we're going to draw off a coach purse. How many know what a coach purse is? Oh, yeah, a lot of hands went up on that. Put your hand down, Josh. You shouldn't know what that is. All right. Thought you were in the military. I don't want you lugging a purse over there, fighting for us over there. Come on, put your hand back down. No. Well, if you're a first-time visitor here today, we're going to draw off. And I looked at the price tag. I couldn't believe what Jen told me it was. $398 for that purse. Are you kidding me? Holy mackerel. Unbelievable. So we're going to draw that off, first-time visitors. If you have first-time visitors, if you haven't put your name in, we're going to make sure we get your name in and then draw it out. That's all that's eligible today. We do a lot of different things, but today it's for first-time visitors only. So even though there's a lot of ladies here today, I'm going to say there's four or five, six, what, I don't know, but first-time visitors here today. So what's that? Okay. If anybody hasn't signed up, first-time visitor, while they're handing out flowers, please go back and sign up right there. First-time visitors for the ladies like that. Mothers for that first-time purse. Now, you guys here, why don't you each take two or three flowers? Start walking around and hand those out for me right there. So we don't scrunch them. After. Then we've got a special Mother's Day video we're going to show you just before Pastor Wayne gives us the message. So we've got a couple special things to do for you here today. And we really appreciate our mothers. We appreciate all the women in general. One of two things. You either are a mother or you have a mother. So you are related to a mother today. So we wish you a happy Mother's Day today. Now, Taylor. I specifically chose you because I thought you could handle this job here. Annie, help your friend Taylor get those flowers. All right. Okay, make sure everybody's got them now. Mothers first, then grandmothers, and then whatever's left, we'll give away to anybody. How's that? How are we doing? Then we've got a special video. I assume Gerald's got that queued up for us and ready to go? Good. Is everybody registered? If you're a first-time lady visitor here today, have you registered? If you haven't, we'll give you bring you a registration card right now. Trust me, I know it's not your first time here. You can... All right, so we got, oh, that is got, look, it even matches Jen's outfit today. What do you think? You're not going to win it, though, Jen. I'm sorry. I know you'd like to. I don't know who put that in for first-time visitors. See, I would have done it for all the ladies, but that's the way it is. So as advertised, we always do it that way. All right, let's see. Caitlin, how about drawing one out for me right here? Need somebody trustworthy, so get it away from Jen to come over to this side. Pam Cooper. Pam, right here. That is going all the way back to Cheyenne, Wyoming. Wow. Pam, congratulations. We're excited for you. That was Jen's idea, by the way, to give that coach purse away. So give Jen a hand. She's always clever about stuff like that. So, all right. At this time, Steve, could I get that light over there, please? We'll get the lights here. We've got a special Mother's Day video for you, and then we'll turn it over to Pastor Wayne. Thank you all.
So how was school today?
Good. I thought the chemistry lab.
No, you did not.
No, that's a long story.
Okay. How was choir?
It was good.
Moms have it so easy. I mean, their lives are fun, simple, and so rewarding. Sometimes I wish, instead of being the dad, I wish I was the mom. Ah, another day of pedicures, reading my magazines, and making myself beautiful. This is the life.
Mom? Mom, tell him to stop copying me.
Mom, tell him to stop copying me.
I'm not kidding.
I'm not kidding.
Mom, do something.
Mom, do something.
Are you serious?
Are you serious?
Mom, are you serious? Why did I ever ask you to help me? I should have known you couldn't fix my hair. I look like a freak. Look at me.
Look at me. Hey, Mom, look at this. Look at me. Come on, Mom. Look at me. Watch this, Mom. Come on, look at this. Watch this. Come on, look at me. Come on, Mom, look at me. Come on, Mom, look at me. Come on.
Report due tomorrow, and I haven't read any of this.
Mom, if you don't help me, I'm gonna fail school and be a loser forever.
You don't expect me to read this all by myself, do you? You don't expect me to eat this, do you?
Seriously, Mom, what is this?
Mom, I'm not gonna eat this.
Dad, can we just go out to eat, please?
Hey, kids, be nice to your mother.
If I eat this, I'm gonna throw up.
Mom, I said I'm gonna throw up.
No!
Mom, I think I'm gonna be sick too.
You're amazing. No, seriously. I don't know how you do it. I'm at a loss for words. Kids, come here. Get in here. Hug your mother. Tell her you love her. We're in the presence of greatness.
Dad.
Not now. Dad's on a roll. This is God's greatest creation, kids.
You're smushing my face.
Sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. And I'm sorry. Because I don't say thank you enough. I mean, the truth is, I don't deserve you. We don't deserve you. And one day is not enough to honor you. We should honor you every day. But how do we say thank you to the woman that means the world to us? I know. We're going to go right now and get you that vacuum cleaner you've had your eye on. Don't speak. This time, we're going name brand, baby. Come on, kids. Let's go make your mom's dreams come true.
Son worked for the coach factory in Jacksonville, and so he took Linda and I one day to the facility and just gave us a tour, and I was just taken back. I mean, I saw purses in there for $1,000, and so that's probably one of the best pocketbooks you can ever buy, and I'm so happy that the first time visitors had an opportunity to pick it up, and I'm glad you're going to take it back to Wyoming. Amen. Appreciate that. Again, one of the things as we make changes here, and all the changes are going to be good, and we're not taking away from anything. This is a Good News Fellowship, and we're on a journey. We're on a spiritual journey, and starting from this Sunday on, we're on a spiritual walk, and I'd love for all of us to walk together. So one of the changes we're going to make, and being a veteran and being so proud of our country, America, and we need to pray for our country. We really do. Don't take it for granted, because I'm telling you what, things are spinning out of control. And I just thank the Lord I'm a Christian. Because no matter what happens, and you know, and I'm not trying to be negative, but no matter what happens, I'm in God's hands. Amen. So I'm going to ask if Josh would come this morning, and then I'm going to ask... let's see, John, would you come? And would y'all hold the flag? John, would you hold the Christian flag? And Josh, would you hold the American flag? And I'd like for all of us to stand, and let's do the Pledge of Allegiance. Amen? Let's respect our flag, what it stands for, because a lot of lives have been lost in defense of this flag. So, I pledge... stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Amen. Amen. Thank you very, very much. I appreciate that. If you have your Bibles, I would like for you to turn to Luke chapter 10. I want to speak this morning about two mothers. Now, all of us here, you know, we had to have a mother. Amen? Whether you like it or not, we had to have a mother. If it wasn't for our mothers, we wouldn't be here. But I want to speak about two mothers, and you know, probably all mothers fit in this category. I love to watch mothers. I love to watch the enthusiasm, the love that mothers have for their kids. I'm learning a lot about some of our people here, some of my friends that I'm meeting, and, you know, being a counselor, being a marriage counselor and writing a marriage manual and being an addiction counselor, I have sat down many, many hours with people that have struggled with marriages that are breaking up, struggling with children that may be addicted to alcohol and drugs. And by the way, I want to say a good morning to my former secretary, Charlotte, who's in Meadville, Pennsylvania right now, watching live stream. Charlotte, we love you and we miss you. And all of our other friends on live stream, thank you for watching. And I pray that you'll come every Sunday. But more than that, leave that computer and come here and be with us in person. Amen? Because we're going to grow, and we're going to grow in God's grace. And my desire as a pastor is to be able to disciple. We're going to be having a Bible Institute here shortly, and we'll probably have it on, and I haven't really sat down and figured a night, but we're going to have it on an off night where you can come, and if you want to grow more in God's grace, I've always had a Bible Institute. I've always believed in discipleship and training not only our converts, but training all of us in God's Word. Amen? So these are just some of the changes we're going to be making, and I'm not going to come in here like a bull in a china closet and make a lot of big changes overnight. I'm not going to do that. But we are going to make changes because we're on a journey, and the changes we're going to make are for you, for your growth. Because, listen, folks, as I said, we're coming into some days now, whether you believe it or not, we're coming into some days now. You've got to have strong faith, or you'll be deceived. How many of you ever read the whole series, Left Behind? And have you ever read that book, Left Behind? Boy, I'm going to tell you something. People say, well, that was just fiction. No, it wasn't. It was done fictional, but it was taken from real-life events that's going to happen. And I'm going to tell you what, folks, you don't want to be left behind. You really don't want to be left behind. So let's look at Luke chapter 10. Let's stand up, please. And I'd like for us to look at verses 39 through 42. Verses 39 through 42. Luke chapter 10, verses 39 through 42. And this is what it says. I'll start with verse 39. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet, and she heard the word. And Martha was coming about much serving. And it came to him and said, Lord, does thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Bid her therefore that she help me. What's she doing? She's complaining. Amen. She is really complaining. She's one-sided. She's only looking at herself. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things. Wow. But one thing is needful, and Mary has chosen that good part which shall not be taken away from her. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have allowed us to be here this morning. Father, there are so many people in many parts of the world, even here in America, Maine, Florida, wherever, that, Father, cannot be in God's house because of many needful things. There are probably many people that are shut in the hospitals. But, Father, we thank those that have the opportunity to be here. Father, my prayer is that our people here will grow in God's grace and that, Lord Jesus Christ, that they'll reach out into the community in which they live. And Father, we pray right now a special blessing upon the journey that Lord Jesus and the fellowship at MDI, that Lord Jesus, that you'll send, you've already got a people, that Father, you'll send workers into the field, that Father, we can reach and touch these people. And I appreciate John's burden for reaching out into all of Hancock County and Lord Jesus having a burden for his people. So, Lord, again, we thank you, we love you, and just pray that you'll bless the services today, for we ask it all in Jesus' name, and everybody says, amen. Amen. You can be seated. Now, you know Martha and Mary were what? They were two sisters, and they were as different as night and day, Kevin. They really were. There's two sisters that love one another, but they were as different as night and day. Any of you ever had sisters that you were, you know, Robin, were y'all different in any way? Yeah. I had three older brothers, and boy, were we different. Man. And I had one sister. But here we find that Mary and Martha, they were sisters. They loved one another. And we find that Martha really was a picture of perfect hospitality. Don't you just love it when people have that heart of wanting to help other people? I love that. I love that. I'll always be encouraging you. You know, always be hospitable. When people come in the doors of the church, or if it's at work or a restaurant, no matter where you go, always show that hospitality, because people will look at you and they'll say, there's something different about that person. You know, because the world expects you to be mean. Amen? The world expects you to be grumpy, just like, you know, just like on the seven dwarfs, grumpy. People, you know, the world expects you to be grumpy. You know, I meet people all the time. I met some at the airport in LaGuardia, and I was buying my wife a pretzel. And I asked the guy, could I have some mustard to go along with the pretzel? Any of you ever eat pretzels and you put mustard on it? Yeah, amen. Mustard. I said, yeah, my wife likes mustard on her pretzel. And I'm not throwing off in any nationality, but I think his brother owned an elephant. And I don't think he understood the culture where we come from. And you know, though I'm from Maine, but I was raised in Florida. There are certain foods that we like that, you know, that probably are different than some people. And I said, yes, I'd like some mustard, please. Let me see if I can find some. And he was really being really grumpy. And then when he gave it to me, I said, I just want you to know that the Lord loves you. He looked at me. I think he thought I was gay or something. I said, the Lord loves you. And he was taken back. Because, you know, a lot of people don't hear that from the right people. People need to hear that more often. Amen? So here we find a picture of a personality, and I hope and pray that you apply this personality to your life, that you are hospitable. Now, you would think that she was perfect, being that she had a spirit of hospitality. But, you know, Martha had a fault that many of us have. Martha was never able to completely rest and be content. You ever know anybody like that? You ever know anybody that you've met a short time? I don't mention no names. I don't believe in that. But you ever met anybody that just don't know how to rest or stay still very long? You know, sometimes you need to rest. Sometimes you need to meet a friend or someone, and I'm trying to meet these kind of friends up here that will say, hey, Pastor King, you want to go trout fishing? Pastor King, do you like salmon fishing? Do you like to go out and catch these little brim or whatever? But sometimes we got to draw away and learn how to rest. I think that's where I'm at right now. I need a time that I can just rest, because the last couple of months it's just been go, 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 go. And I realize, I look at my own personality and I realize it's time for me to pull away and just get away for a day or so. And so I have the same fault. My wife she's always warning me. She was afraid that when I came up here, because she'll know sometimes I'll work 18, 20 hours a day if I have to get the job done. And she's always saying, Wayne, take time to rest. Now, Mary, her sister's totally different, and she's not really in the arena of hospitality. She has another part of a personality. She's more interested in the conversation of today's menu. In other words, she wants to know, what do you like to eat? You know, my father gave me his bean pot that his mother had had, Hope. And this bean pot, I don't know how old it is. I'll learn. Forgive me on live stream. Forgive me. I'm learning. But I'm getting ready, when we have a fellowship here, I'm getting ready to make some good Maine northern baked beans that I cook in the oven for 8-9 hours. Amen. I got my daddy's recipe. Don't kid you. My dad was in the restaurant business, and my dad, he was a French chef. He was full French. And my dad could cook. You just ask my wife. My dad could cook. But he gave me his recipe and on his homemade baked beans, and I love to put those, you know, I've been using yellow eyed peas and get my molasses and get my brown sugar and get my salt pork and my dried mustard and my onion and put it all together and put it in the oven and let that thing cook for about 7, 8, 9 hours and have some good old brown bread and some of those big all meat wieners. And when you walk in the house and you smell those baked beans, you'll say, "Oh, I'm at the marriage supper of the Lamb." I can see Kevin over there right now saying, "Go ahead and make them." So Mary, she is more interested in today's menu. Now, Mary loves to sit at the feet of Jesus, and Martha is busy with much serving. The sisters were close friends. They really were. And they loved one another. But from time to time, they did argue about things. Now, in verse 40, Martha directs her anger toward Jesus. You see, when people don't get their way, this is where you have to be careful. This is what I, as a counselor, and if you know me long enough, I don't like to be around this arena. I don't like people running to me and say, "Well, Pastor, so-and-so didn't do things the way I want them to do it." Don't do that with me. Because there are things that other people could say about you. Amen? Don't complain about one another. You know what makes a great church, a great team, is unity. Is unity. Man, I can't wait. And I mean this, and don't get me wrong. I love music. I can't wait till Susan gets to feeling better, and she comes back and gets on that saxophone. Man, I love a good sax. Now, next Sunday, Lord willing, I didn't play this Sunday because I heard Kevin say, and I know musicians are like that way. But Lord willing, next Sunday, next week, I'm going to practice. But next week, you're going to see me up here on the congas. I play the congas. Now, when we sing that song, One Love, oh, my. You're going to see Pastor King on them congas. You're going to see me get a little bit of sister act in me. Like my wife, you're going to see a little Whoopi Goldberg in me. Because you see, serving the Lord has a sense of excitement. Amen? And so here we find that Martha and Mary, they're kind of going at it. They go to Jesus and said, "Jesus, you've got to straighten the problem out." But you know what happened? The Lord was getting ready to teach Martha and Mary that only Jesus Christ can set us free from a life that tries to seek others. You know what happens today? I'm going to try to always seek the approval of God before I seek the approval of man. Because if I am being honest with God, and if I'm being honest to God's word, and I'm doing what God wants me to do, then I don't have to seek the approval of man. Amen? I don't need you to come up and pat me on the back and say, like so many churches, "Boy, that was a tremendously good sermon." No, give all the glory to God, because God is the one that lays the message on my heart and Kevin's heart of all these pastors and missionaries around the world. Let's give God the glory. Amen? Because really, in essence, Jesus Christ is in our midst right now. And mothers, if it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here. You think about it. You think about it. I wrote a little thing on my Facebook page yesterday, and I was praising God for mothers, and someone wrote me back and said, "Yeah, and how about our adopted mothers?" And I said, "Yeah, amen, you're right, exactly right. I have a lot of adopted mothers, people that are like mothers to me." But you know, I thank God for each and every one of you. And you're very special. And all of us have different personalities. Heather has a different personality than my wife, Linda. Linda has a different personality than Jen. Jen has a different personality than T, Jody, or any one of us. We're all different, but we have one attribute that all of us should have, and that's that we have a desire to serve God. I heard Ken's testimony yesterday, and I'm just getting to know some of our people. And it's good to get to know people. It's good to know some of the background they come from, because then you're able to pray more effectively. And Linda and I was going home from the fellowship last night, and I said, Linda, I did not know some of the background that some of our people have. But I said, I'm so glad that I'm able to know, because I can pray more effectively. But I thank God, for no matter what background we have, it surely didn't stop Kim from praising God. It sure hasn't stopped Kevin from praising God. How about you, folks? Think about it. How about you? Is your life filled with purpose? Is your life filled with peace? Or does your life remind you of Martha? The good news is that you can experience God's rest and acceptance today. Matthew 11:28 is one of my favorite verses of Scripture. I never, ever like to close a service without letting you know that there's a special guest here right now. And you know, Brad, Robin, you know who our special guest is? You know who our special guest is right now? And he's the one that invited us, and he's the one that we're here, is the Lord Jesus Christ. He's standing here right now. You can't see him, but he's here. Another thing you can't see the host of angels that he brings with him. But if you study the Word of God, you'll know that at any one time, we have a host of angels all about us. You just don't see them, but they're here. We had a man in our church. He was from Jamaica. His name was Frank Scarlett. And Frank's gone on to be with the Lord now. I preached his funeral probably 12 years ago. Frank was Jamaican. Frank came to Shiloh. He said, Pastor, man, you come to my people. He said, you come to my people with a heart, man. You left America to come down here to Jamaica, man, to know my people. He said, I love you, man. I appreciate you, man. He said, I want you to know that you'll have no problem. And Frank would always say, now Frank was a little older. My wife knows where I'm going with this. Frank wasn't the best driver in the world. Ron? He wasn't the best driver in the world, believe me. Though they drove on the left-hand side of the road in Jamaica, when you got in a car with Frank, you better know for sure that you're saved. Frank one day said, Pastor King, man, he says, I want to take you to get a hamburger, man. He says, I know you like hamburgers. So he said, come on, you go with me, I drive. So I got in the car with him, we're going down the road. I said, Frank, pull over to the side of the road right now. Let me drive. No, man, no big problem. My guardian angel jumped out the window. And he's in glory right now. The man really loved the Lord with all of his heart. But Jesus is standing right here, right now. And I know that many of you, the world likes to look at you, and they like to think that you're a super mom. But you, some of you mothers, you have your problems too, don't you? You have your weaknesses. You have your hard times. You know what the Lord wants? He wants you to devote your love to Him. Martha remembered that the Lord, and she remembered the Lord loved her. Mary realized the Lord loved her. And they were able to work their problems out. And you know what? They were an example to a lot of people. When you go ahead and read the Word of God, you'll find out how God used them greatly. And you know, moms, the Lord's going to use you greatly as well. Whether you're here in Maine or you go back to Cheyenne, Wyoming, the Lord's going to use you greatly. I believe that with all my heart. But I want you to picture right now, as we all stand up, I want you to picture Jesus Christ is standing right now with his arms open wide. He's standing here. You can't see him. His host of angels, his protectorate, his army. He's standing with his arms open wide, and he's looking at you, and he's reaching into your heart. Are you willing to come with every head bowed, every eye closed? I'm the only one looking about. I'll ask John if he'll look about. Kevin's looking about. Is there anybody right here, right now, let's say, Pastor King, I know that Jesus Christ is standing with his arms open wide, and he says, all ye who labor and heavy laden, come unto me, I'll give you rest. Pastor King, I really need rest. I don't know right now if I died today, if I'd go to heaven. I don't have that assurance. And I know that some of the different times I've been here, that there are people that raise their hand over and over because you know what? If you ever get saved, salvation sticks. It really does. See, I believe once saved, always saved. Oh, yeah, Satan will knock on your door. But if you're here this morning and you need the Lord, you just remember Jesus is standing here right now. Anybody will say, Pastor King, I need prayer about salvation. Is there any like that right now? Pastor King, I don't know if I'm saved. Would you raise your hand? Pastor, I really don't know. I see one hand. You can put that hand down. Anybody else? Well, I want to say this. If you're here and you don't know, Jesus is standing right now and says, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, you come unto me. I'll give you rest. If you're here and you don't know you're saved, then I want you to take a walk. I want you to take a first step and just come down here and let me pray for you. Is there one like that right now that will come and say, Pastor King, I don't know I'm saved, and if you'll come, just step out right now. Let me pray for you. Amen. Is there anyone like that would want to step out? I'm not going to embarrass you. Never will. That's one thing I'll never do is embarrass anybody. Anybody else need to come? Anybody else need to come? Heavenly Father, Lord, I pray, Lord Jesus, right now, that you know the heart of every believer here. You know the heart of every person. I'm asking right now that every believer that knows you will be praying that souls will be saved. Lord, this young lady that has come forth, Lord, I just pray that you'll continue to speak to her heart. And Lord, I want to talk to her after the service. And Lord, you want to talk to her. You're already talking to her. So Lord, if there's anybody else that just needs to step out, Lord, just burden her heart to come, because salvation is the most important decision that anybody will ever make. Lord, I'm so excited this past week as Kevin and Kim were going down the road and it was pouring down rain. They saw an individual on the side of the road. They didn't even know him. And it takes faith today, especially in today's world, to stop and say, hey, how about getting in? They took him out to eat, bought him a meal, and you know what? They were able to lead him to the Lord. And that's what it's all about. Amen. That's the only reason I'm up here, folks. I'm not up here for any other reason. I want to see souls saved, lives changed, and families put back together. And when I'm when I'm at a point where I'm at no effect anymore, then something's wrong. But that's why I'm here, because I want to see souls saved and lives changed. Heavenly Father, thank you for our mothers. Thank you for this very blessed service. Thank you, Lord, as we march on our journey. And Lord, today really was the beginning of a journey, the Journey Church here. And Lord, I just pray now every week that we'll grow more and more and more. And as I reach out more in the community and meet more people, and we invite more people to come to church, Lord Jesus, we'll see your church grow. And that's what it's all about. Thank you for Josh. Thank you, Lord, for allowing him, Father, to have finished his training, and now he's getting ready to go to South Korea. Lord, that old crazy madman from the North, North Korea, whatever his name is, Father, he's just a bunch of bag, a whim. But we got some young soldiers like Josh that's going to defend our country, and I thank you, Lord, for them. Continue to be with Josh, and he'll make good Christian friends no matter where he goes. And again, Lord, thank you for the visitors. Thank you, Lord, for all those who came today. And thank you for our dear friends from Wyoming. Give them a good visit here. And when they go back to Wyoming, they can go back and say, hey, we met some new friends there right outside Bar Harbor, Maine. And they'll be praying for us. I believe that this family will be praying for us from now on. Thank you, Lord, for we ask it all in Jesus' name. And everybody says what? Amen. God bless you. You can be seated. How many of you enjoyed the service today? Have a beautiful Mother's Day. And if you have a living mother, and if she's close, I know you probably have already encouraged your mother. I know some people that they're at ends with their mother, at odds with their mother. But if you ever like that, pray for your mother, amen, because they are special people. And again, may God's grace go with you. No matter what you do this day, I just pray that God will be there with you. Let's all stand, be dismissed. John, you got anything that you'd like to say?
Next week, there's going to be a lady baptized.
Yes.
Filled up at 85 degree temperature.
Amen. Baptism next Sunday. Okay, let's all stand. And God bless you. And Lord willing, we'll see you next Sunday. You're dismissed. God bless you.